Welcome back, everybody, to Let's Play Parasite Eve 2. I am your host, Alexander Frost, and this is episode 15. Now, when last we left off, we barely escaped the glutton and the incinerator, which was going to burn us down, and Kyle here, by some means or another, got into the shelter. I do not trust the man. We also got our hands on a very nice little item. The medicine wheel, oh yes. We also got a belt pouch, which I want to save. Yes. Very good reason why. But I'm completely full on items. Completely full. This is a shotgun. Completely empty. Oh no, there's still some firefly rounds left. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to put the grenade launcher in there. No, those are airburst. And then load them with airburst rounds. They're not quite as powerful as normal grenade rounds, but for right now, they're just taking up space. And I do not want to use this belt pouch. I want to save it because we're going to get some good stuff. Trust me. Trust me when I say this! I should warn you folks, I've only gotten about 3 or 4 hours of sleep, thanks to Mass Effect 3, which I just bought, so, I'm probably gonna be a little slap happy. Ha ha! So you might well just get used to it. Also, the same problem I was having with my headset with Dragon's Dogma does not appear to apply to PS2 and PS1 games. I don't know why. I don't know why. It's some crazy voodoo magic, man. But whatever the case may be, as far as Dragon's Dogma is concerned, I am not going to start recording that until my Rosetta Stone headphones show up, which should be middle to late this week. So all will be well then, and I'll be able to record some awesome kick-ass headphones again, and I won't make the same mistake I made last time. With my last two headsets, I used the Rosetta Stone headphones for everything. I listened to them, I recorded with them, and it was ultimately when I was using them that they got broken. However, this time around, I'm only going to use it strictly for recording purposes. If I want to actually listen to anything, I'll just plug in my old headphones, which is just fine, because that's sort of what I'm doing right now with this headset for the PS3. So, without further ado, you came here to see me kill monsters and solve riddles and crimes and fuck, I am tired as hell. this door is locked. We're going to take Kyle's advice and we are going to get the hell out of here. Because this place is poopy and stinky and I do not like it. Everything has tried to kill us since we arrived. Oh look, a mad chaser. Pretty easy pickings. Oh, Kyle saved us a little ammunition. Oh, thank you, Kyle. That doesn't mean I like you. I might like you. I don't. Oh no. Now, just because you have the medicine meal? The medicine meal. A meal that cures you of all your ailments. Just because you have the medicine wheel does not necessarily mean you're gonna get a bonus item on every battle. If you get an item, usually there's a good chance you'll get one. Now, I'm probably gonna get an item in this battle. I'm going to turn on energy shot because these guys, we do not want Kyle fucking with them, even though he's clearly doing just that. Kyle has the tendency to, oh, nice shot, Kyle, of just walking straight into the enemy when really he should be backing off. He does not use strategy of any kind. I shot a wall. I didn't get an item. Well, tits. It's okay. I'm mad. We'll get around that corner now. Well, golly gee willikers, I could stay down here amongst the garbage and the water that obviously is not fit for drinking, or I could go up. Oh, it's another bog diver. Damn it. These things. Dead? Dead. There was only one. Excellent. Now, in order to proceed onwards, we can't go down these stairs into the water. We have to figure out this floodgate puzzle. Now, it's actually pretty simple. Except that I don't have the puzzle for it. All I have is... What do I need to look for? It's back over here. I remember now. It's been a few weeks since I played, but I remember now. It's right here. There's an inspection panel with a memo attached. Check for occupants before opening the floodgate. Well, the only thing in there are NMCs and ANMCs, so fuck them. Let the rats, roaches, and spiders drown. But first, count their legs. Enter the total and raise the lever. It said let the rats, roaches, and spiders die. Alright, well, rats have 4 legs. Roaches are insects, so they have 6 legs, and spiders have 8, so that's 8, 6, and 4. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, that's 18. Yes, I still count on my fingers. Bite me. Enter a tens digit. Now enter a ones digit. Go. Raise the lever. Floodgate lock released. Excellent. Here's what I don't get. Here you can clearly see the water is blue, is somewhat pristine and clean and nice looking. You might take a drink from it if you were really thirsty. You know, in spite of the what clearly looks like skulls at the bottom. But now it's all poopy and dirty and nasty and rusty looking. And there are monsters in it, right now. Over this way. Go through the gate. Atta girl. Now there ought to be a bog diver around here somewhere. There we go. Now, I know it looks like he's eager to get a hold of me, but I do not think he can actually hurt me. Still, let's not test this theory. Thank you, Kyle, for making me waste a grenade. For those of you who couldn't figure out what he just did, Kyle, the man here, just used his flamethrower through the corner. It clipped through and damaged that damn thing. Now, we can't go up this way yet, but we will very, 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 very soon. Oh, yes. Because we don't want to stay here in the shelter anymore. It is full of pain and ouch and not niceness. Pardon me. Now let's wait till they get closer. Seemed to work pretty good. Good job, Kyle. Way to stand there and take it like a bro. Like a pro, even. Okay, the airburst grenades aren't bad. I guess I gave them more of a bad rap than I should have. Now, in order to get out of here... this way? Yes. In order to get out of here, we have to activate the full moon gate. Okay, that's easy enough. There's something written on the LCD screen. Enter a tens digit. Alright, well... We don't know for sure. There's obviously some kind of puzzle somewhere... just like before. So let's go and find it. It shouldn't be too far off. Shouldn't be. Is it? No, it's not. The reason why is because it's actually a pretty easy puzzle. First things first, we're gonna go back this way. We're gonna clear this area out for a little extra BP before we go. Besides, I want to use these grenades. Alright, I got this. A little energy shot. Because this is my last airburst. Perfect! You loaded it with nothing, Aya. It is an empty gun. Alright, so now I have only my normal grenades, which I will load... as an emergency, but for the most part, I'm going to be switching back to the M4 Hammer for now. Because it's a good gun, and I do like it. We freed up a couple of spots in our inventory, which we need. This area's starting to look a little familiar. It should. This is the door that was unlocked. Or that I should say, that was locked back at the incinerator control room. Now from here we have two choices. One, we could take Kyle's advice and leave. Or, we could take this elevator. This elevator, which if I remember correctly, was jammed before, and is the elevator down at the elevator hall. We unjam it, we can get back up. Or, like I said, we could take Kyle's advice and leave. And since we want to go for the good ending in the game, we want to keep going. Now, if this were Nightmare Mode or Scavenger Mode, if this were Scavenger Mode, no. I would say, fuck that, we're going to continue onwards. We don't want to leave, because we don't know what else is out there. All kinds of nastiness going on. All kinds of nastiness. So how does one fall? How does one solve the Full Moon Gate puzzle? Well, if you're in school, you should know this, and by that I mean elementary school. It's pretty simple, if you know anything about the lunar cycle. When does the full moon usually occur? Now, it doesn't have a set time, because the months are constantly changing. Some months have 31 days, some have 30, one has 28, and every 4 years it has 29. So understandably, it's never going to be exactly the same every month, but we do know that it is roughly somewhere in the middle of the month. So, since there are more days that have 30 than there are 31, we can safely assume that it's 15. By process of elimination, we could say 14 or 16. Hell, since we know it's in the middle of the month, we could go as far as 13 and 17. Going to 12 and 18 would just be stretching it too far. So now the full moon gate is open. We can get the hell out of here. Or Hasmana. For those of you who don't know what Hasmana is, watch Farscape. It is a sci-fi series that started in the, I want to say, early 2000s. Great show. I've been watching it on Netscape? Netflix. And I watched that show originally when it first started on Sci-fi, when it was brand spanking new every Friday night. Sci-fi had such great shows then. Back when it was called Sci-fi, S-C-I-F-I, not S-Y, whatever the hell they're doing now. So, you're probably wondering, where exactly does this lead? Well, folks, I tell you, this is where it leads. It leads all the way back to Dryfield. Oh, let's split up, you say? By all means, you go check out the shelter and get eaten. Go get eaten. I don't care. He's not a good man. Hey, Flint, what's up, buddy? I realize it's very dark, and I'm going to try and edit that using YouTube's new features. So hopefully it should actually look better than it does. Well, to me. Now, here's the thing. We're supposed to follow Flint, and that's fine. And as you can see, Dryfield has gone to shit since we've been gone. Now, I don't normally do this, and I find this incredibly unprofessional, but I do need to check the strategy guide real quick. And here is the reason why. Dryfield is a huge, huge hot zone right now. Plenty of opportunities to get BP. But I want to check and see... Oh, dear Lord. There we go. I want to check and see if, by going to see Mr. Douglas first, we will trigger another hot zone. Because I want to clear everything out first to get as much BP as I can, then go back and trigger the next hot zone. Okay, let's see. Na 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 na. It looks like, boys and girls, that it does not matter. Dryfield is safe. This is the last hot zone we will have to deal with in Dryfield, supposedly. So we could actually go and see Mr. Flint, or we could We could go see Mr. Douglas, or we could follow Flint now. Well, first thing is first. I want to get... Oh. Yeah, I believe he is leading us to the water tower. Before we do that, though... Actually, no, this works to my advantage because I'm heading in the direction I want to go. Is this area full of enemies? No, it's not. The water tower is. I want to go to my room first and foremost. Now, even though it says there are enemies here... Whoa, there are enemies here. How about that? Can't reach him. That would be why I can't reach him. No, there was just the one mad chaser? Okay. Bonus items! What do we get? What do we get? Oh, come on! Another belt pouch? Well, I know what this bottle is. It's eau de toilette or whatever. Someone tell me how to pronounce that. I don't know. It induces berserker. I'm pretty sure I've been over this before, how I don't like the whole idea of inducing berserker, so I'm not going to do it. I'm going to put those belt pouches away for right now. I'll be back, Flint. Just hang on. Settle, puppy. Settle. Before I do anything, though, I need to go on ahead and take the grenade pistol out. Because I'm not going to need it anymore. Same with the SP-12 shotgun. It's a good shotgun. It's been a great shotgun, but one, I don't have any more shotgun shells. Two, more importantly, I'm about to get a better one. Yes, there is a better one. That's the bathroom. That's the bed. Come on, Aya. There we go. Now, I have to remember, this place only has a... Oh, shit! I had another belt pouch! This whole time! I get three belt pouches! Shit!
Why don't you just use one on the armor you have?
Because... gotta get better armor soon. I'm gonna go ahead and take these stims. I'm gonna put the SP-12 and the grenade launcher in their place, and then I'm just gonna discard those stims, because I don't use stims. I don't use the stims or the panacea. I don't use them. But the fact remains, I'm still... Oh, actually, I'm doing okay on items. Yes, get rid of it. I don't need it. Don't use it. There we go. Okay, so I have 5 slots open. Since 2 of those are going to be in my attachments, that's 3. I'm actually doing alright. I got plenty of recovery items and MP boosts, and I am okay with what I have. I'm usually more minded on... HP items than anything. Alright, Flint. Alright, let's see what's got your panties in a twist. You still here? Yeah, you're still here. You barked. I heard you. Alright, go back to Mr. Douglas. I got things from here. Wait, someone's up here? Is that Pierce? No. They don't like electricity very much. Spartan and Hydra rounds. Once again, I do not have a 9. No, I will keep the Spartan rounds. I'll keep the Spartan rounds. I'll discard the Hydra rounds because I can get free Hydra rounds back at the shelter, so it's all good. Oh, not cool. Way to be like Carlos from Resident Evil 3. Yeah, you're kind of looking like crap. We'll take care of you. And you didn't even bring a gun? He just spit an SUV key out of his mouth. That is disgusting. Well, at this point, if we wanted to go for the true and best ending, we have two options. We could save Pierce, or we could take his key and leave. He is specifically the reason, well, one of two reasons why I came back to Dryfield. We will save him. We will save him. Because I do want to advance the story along a fair ways. Now, remember how I said there was a certain item that we were definitely going to need if we wanted to get, if we really wanted to see things along? Trust me. It's the rabbits! Oh, wait, how many of you are there? Zero now. And it looks like... which would be the faster way to go? No, I can't go through the balcony because of the hole that was left there by the boss burner. Damn it, I have to go this way. So I need to clear a path first. That won't be a problem. Clear a path, clear a path. I'm really in the mood to record, so I know my body's telling me, go and record more than one episode today. And I'm like, nah. One episode today. If I do record more, though, I just won't record more. Oh, hi. Yeah, I really don't want to be here. Or here. Oh, aren't you just a special little boy? Went and ran himself into the wall. No. There it is. Hey, do you like electricity? Yeah, I didn't think so. Remember this? Ice. Ice for Pierce? Yes. Now it is important to note that ice in this game is just like ice in real life. It will melt. So if you dawdle and take your sweet time, you will return to Pierce with a bag of water. You don't want to do that. So the idea is you have to go and get him some ice. That's it. No, get in there. There you go. And it's kind of a long run, you know. This is perhaps the only real, quote-unquote, fetch quest that this game has that makes you go back and forth in a manner that's almost mind-numbing. Especially considering the pace the rest of the game has set about, you know, being action-y and strategic and fighting and all that good stuff. Pierce. Wake your ass up. Feeling better? Good. A cola? Well, thank you. Don't really need it. All right. And thus the quest begins. And so finally, we finish. We've saved Pierce. All is well. And what did we get for our efforts? Why, we got some cola, MP boost 2, and a charm? The Ofuda charm. Now, just like the other items that we have received thus far. Yes, I'm going through the guide again because I do not remember off the top of my head what it does. And I want to be absolutely, positively sure I get it right. Let's see. The banana. Ah, yes. The Ofuda charm, if I use it, will increase any one of my Earth PE abilities by 1. However, if I attach it, this increases my attack power with any weapon I use by 50%. I'd say that is definitely well worth having. So with the holy water to give us more resistance to attacks, the Ofuda to make us stronger, and the medicine wheel to give us more? We are going places. And we got Pierce's SUV key, so there's some stuff in there that is definitely worth getting our grubby little mitts on. So we're going to go and get our reward. Ew. As you saw in that previous segment when I was running back and forth, I have a little bit of trouble controlling Eye sometimes. I can't get her to make her smooth, curving run like I like. To curve around corners and such. Sometimes she just stops because I have to turn too far. And that does make it a little bit tricky. Or I overturn and end up missing the corner and get caught on it and go backwards. It is troublesome. And part of it, I think, is I've always had this problem controlling Aya. It's always been this way. And the other part of it is I think, I'm not sure what I was gonna say. It slipped my mind. Well, it's not important. But before we can claim our prize from the SUV, we gotta fight for it. As you can see, we are much stronger. We are dropping these guys in one burst of machine gun fire. Almost. That's something we couldn't do before. Now you're probably wondering, why is the battle music still playing? I'm clearly not locking on to anything. Simple. They're zebra stalkers. Or, there it is. It was either going to be zebra stalkers or scavengers. I don't remember which. And I totally meant to use a cola. Wait, I still can. There we go. So it was good that I got injured. It was good that I got hurt. Go to the back of the car.
There you go.
Oh, yes. And what do we get? What reward awaits us? A tactical vest! Yes! Yes! And... oh... a cylinder of lipstick? What? What is this? Well, we know what the tactical vest does. It gives us 50 HP, 10 MP, kind of low, and 7 attachments. It also gives us quick fire and HP recovery. That means we can fire our weapons faster, or at least bring our weapons up faster, so that means heavy weapons like the M4 that we've been lugging around, the grenade launcher and such, we'll be able to lift them and fire them faster. Has 7 attachments. I have 3 belt pouches upstairs in the motel! However, this item? Oh, this item. The lipstick! If I use it, I increase my max MP by 1 and refill my MP, but if I attach it, I resist silence. I will never be forced to never cast again. Of course, as you can see, I don't have any... oh, I do have room for it. Excellent. Now, before we call this a video, I'm gonna do a jump cut, of course. But before we end this, is there anything in this trunk that is worth my time? There does not appear to be. There appears to be a plethora of healing items. Oh my god, so many healing items. I have more MP boosts than I will probably ever need. So let's go on ahead and put that in there. The protein capsule, I really need to use. I really need to use that, because I know I'm going to get more soon. So you know what? I'm going to go on ahead and use it. That's the select button. No, it's in here. Use that. And then I'll probably put another MP recovery in its place. There we go. The thing I have to be careful of is I can accidentally use the lipstick attachment in battle to recover my MP, so I have to be very careful and not use it. Now, I believe that is all that I can do for this video. There's still plenty of Dryfield that needs cleaning up, and when the next video starts, we'll be upstairs in our motel room, safe, sound, and whole, and we will come up with a plan of attack, figuring out where we want to go to clean up Dryfield. But for now, we are going to call it a day. Until next time, everyone!